Hello, today is July 7th. It is day 10. Just wanted to give you guys an update. As you can see, the swelling went down. It's swollen about from right here, all this, right here. Let's see. Today I went to the surgeon and he said I was doing really good. He added more rubber bands. I'm gonna show you. And the reason I didn't have any in the front was because one of my buttons had broken during surgery, so he said that's why I didn't have any. So he put some of them on the ones that weren't broken. And then I went straight to the orthodontist right after I got out. And he put a button and he put a rubber band. I'm not able to open them. I can't replace the rubber bands myself. I have wires. Today the surgeon actually tightened them and they're pretty bad. I mean, it hurts. I took some of my Vicodin. It's probably the most pain that I've had was today. So I'm gonna try to show you my buttons and my rubber bands. So you guys could kind of see, since I don't have braces. I'm not your typical underbite surgery candidate, but still had it done. These are the ones he added today. So you can see I have this one here. All those are bands. I have the buttons up here. I don't know why, but this side seems to hurt more. And I don't know if they had more trouble doing this side, but my lips right here hurt more, so that's why I'm able to show you better with this side. I mean, it looks pretty gross, but I still, as you can see, I'm bleeding. This right here, my gum is really sensitive, and most of the time if I touch it, see, starts bleeding a little bit. But besides that, I mean, everything's fine. Swelling, it's going down. As for numbness, I can feel this part right here. From here to here, I have no feeling. He poked me with like a needle. I could feel it up to here. And then once he got here, I can't feel that at all. But down here, I could feel my finger, just not 100%. This is the part that's the most swollen right here. But I just make sure that I have my ice packs on. 20 minutes on, 20 minutes off. They said I was doing really good compared to other people. I think it's because I've made sure that I have my ice packs on all the time. Sometimes it's easier if I just get one and I do 20 minutes. And then that way, while I'm doing these 20 minutes, when I'm done with this side, then I could go back. Or I'll go 20, 20, and 20. And then I'll start all over again. Or at night, I just, let me get my ice pack. My ice pack. So I'll just go 20. I'll go like 20 like this. Another 20. And at night, I'm supposed to sleep with pillows, like if you were in the hospital. So what I do is I put a towel because it gets this ice pack. It doesn't have any moisture, but for some reason at night, I think it's because my body heat and then the water, it seems like I wake up wet. So I put on my towel. What I do is I lay down, then I put this right here, then I get my ice pack, and I kind of fix it for the ice to go like this, and that's how I sleep, and I don't move at all at night. Lately, I've been waking up a lot, just because sometimes I get like a sharp pain over here. I don't know why. These past couple of days, I haven't been able to sleep, but I mean, overall, it's good. I'm just saving my Vicodin for when it only hurts a lot. But I still take my other medicine, and it's been fine. So, I hope you guys can really see my buttons. And then, they did a x-ray, and they actually did the incision somewhere right here, like the screw. But that's about it. I'll try to do another video, maybe when I see that some of this swelling has gone down or something. But, I mean, I haven't had a lot of new things to show you guys, except for the swelling. So I'll see you guys next time.